Patrick, from day one to now, how would you assess how camp went for you guys? How much you improved from the first time you got here today?
I thought it was a good camp. We improved on a lot of stuff. We didn't add a lot of new receivers, but getting those new receivers in and getting them flowing around, and the guys that have been here for the second year, you can see the improvements on how they practice. I thought it was a good camp, offense, defense, and special teams. We kind of just flew around, and we competed every day, which you always want.
Over the last month, who were some of the guys behind your eyes, both sides of the ball?
Yeah, I mean, I thought the offensive line did a great job throughout camp, just battling. I mean, there's some long days, a lot of play. I thought they did a good job of keeping that mentality throughout practice. I thought the DBs, a lot of those young DBs were moving around everywhere. Spags is really testing them to see what they could really do, and I thought they did a great job of responding to that. But I thought that throughout, I mean, there was days where the offense got the defense, today's defense got the offense, and that's what you want in a camp, is you want a competitive, and every day guys going out there competing.
Patrick, why is short yardage been a little bit of a problem for you guys?
Probably because my kneecap was on the side of my leg. I think we were doing pretty good until that. We were really good at it until last year. I mean, last year we didn't do very well at it, so we didn't get the one in the first one, the preseason. So we've went back and kind of evaluated it, and hopefully by the time season comes around, we can get back to converting those.
Any discussion with Andy about putting that quarterback sneak back in the game?
I always want to, because I always say that I haven't got stopped yet, but because even the one that my knee I got hurt on, I still got the first down. I'm pretty sure he's not going to let me do it unless it's like for the Super Bowl or not. So I might have to call my own number in the Super Bowl if we get there.
Patrick, what did you see as far as growth with your two first-year receivers you've been working with, Rashee Rice and then Justin Ross?
I thought they did a great job. I think y'all know as much as everybody that that receiving position, that DB position, that training camp is the hardest place to be. I mean, just how much running that we do. I thought those guys got better and better, and they learned how to finish and how to keep that mentality throughout entire practice. And, I mean, their talent is, I mean, they have the talent of most talent I think I've seen out of all every receiver that I've always been in. They have a lot of talent, but you have to learn how to be consistent every single day. And I think they got better and better at that as they continue to go.
Pat, this is your sixth or seventh year in St. Joseph, and Coach Reed's always really complimentary of the hospitality and service here. I know dorm life isn't super glamorous, but what do you appreciate most just about this particular venue and setup for camp?
I think I just I really am interested, and I really have a fun time with just meeting people. A lot of times when you're in the building, you're with the offense, even though you have some team meetings, you don't get to see those defensive guys except for really on the traveling on game day and that weekend. And so being able to eat lunch, go to Chick-fil-A, go get some pizza, whatever it is, with just different guys that you're not around all year long, you build those relationships. And I think that's what St. Joe's – the best part about St. Joe is that you get out here and you really get to see those guys you don't see maybe as much throughout the year and build those relationships. And that's what builds that bond that you have whenever times get tough during the regular season.
What do you want to see in game two, going from preseason game number one to number two?
It's better energy, better urgency just from the get-go. I thought the young guys did a great job in the second half of kind of picking it up. I think just from the get-go, offense and defense, just having that urgency to go out there and compete. It's a preseason game, and obviously the results don't necessarily matter, but they do if you want to build a culture of winning. And we have a lot of young guys, and even though they won a Super Bowl, they have to know how to respond and get even better the second year. And so I think just having a better urgency from the get-go throughout the entire game, not as much the result. You obviously want to win, but you want to have that mentality throughout the entire game.
Patrick, camp sets the tone for the whole season, right? Like, you've been around a couple years where you guys didn't make the Super Bowl. Can you tell the difference between a good camp when you guys have made to the Super Bowl?
You can. I think more is just the day-to-day grind throughout the entire camp and into the regular season and throughout the season. You have to keep that mentality. I've had some great camps where we came in and that mentality didn't go through the entire season and you didn't get the payoff that you wanted. I feel like we had a great camp, we have to have that mentality. It's not done. I mean, we still got weeks of practice getting ready for the game. That first regular season game against a Detroit Lions team that's it's hungry and ready to come out there and try to beat us. And so we have to have that mentality. We can't just be satisfied with how camp went. We have to keep that mentality throughout the entire season.
Patrick, going back to Arizona this weekend, you know, where there's one Super Bowl loss, so is there going to be a couple of times where you're going to kind of look over and reminisce like, hey, did you pull it out stuff?
I mean, maybe for like a second. I think we have a lot of stuff that we continue to work on. I kind of said it after the ring ceremony. It was kind of, it's it. We're trying to go back and get another one. And so you'll, I'm sure when I first step on the field, there'll be a little bit of looking around and saying, like, hey, man, it was a great time last time we were here, but we got a job to do, and that's to get better, play against a Cardinals team that played a really good first preseason game. And so we know it's going to be a mentality of going out there and playing our best football.
Last one. What would you like to see from this team that improved upon as you leave this camp in preparation for the season?
Yeah, I think it's just that mindset. I mean, the mindset of every single day just getting being, you know, making yourself better and getting the best out of it is something that you have to continue to preach and continue to do with any football team. And so there's a lot of parity in this league. Anybody can beat anybody. I think y'all know that. And so we have to have that mentality every single day or we'll get beaten, especially in the division that we are in the AFC West and the AFC. Every single week, every opponent we play is going to play us to the best of their ability, so we have to make sure that we go out there with that mentality.
All right, thank you.